Hello, my name is Steven. Welcome to Hyfindr Tech Talks. In this series, we focus on understanding the technology that makes the hydrogen economy work. Today, we're going to talk about air blowers, cathode blowers, and I am particularly delighted to have a guest today who's been working on this for the last years. He is an electrical engineer, works with Becker, and his name is Marc Franzbäcker. Hi, Marc.
Thank you, Steven. Thank you for the warm welcome.
Thank you. Thank you that you made it here. And I'm happy that you also brought something along with you. What is this that we have here on the table?
Yeah, this is called VSF 2.50. And this is the second generation of our small side channel blowers. Can be used as a cathode blower for stationary fuel cells. Second generation because we started doing this in 2005. Mm-hmm. It's small, it's modular, it's touchless, oil-free, and frequency controlled, mm-hmm. and it even can replace the mass flow meters in the fuel cell.
Okay, now you've said so many things, mass flow meters, but I'd like to start at the beginning. So you say this is a cathode blower. Okay, so to be honest, at the beginning I was often confused with what's a blower and what is a compressor. So you make blowers or do you make compressors? Can you help us there? What's the difference between a blower and a compressor?
Well, Steven, no really hard definition is known to me, but a compressor, the main purpose is to compress air.
Yes.
A blower is, or the function is to create a certain flow. Mm-hmm. But there is no hard definition for that. So both wordings are known to me, side channel or turbo blowers or compressors. So basically can be both.
Oh, so this can this be a compressor as well? Could you consider this as a compressor?
This is also, if you type it in Google, you find side channel compressor, find turbo compressor, both is possible.
Okay,
yes.
Possible. Okay, but the tendency is more that the blowers are more, you know, oriented to moving a steady flow of air, whereas a compressor will actually have a higher delta P.
Correct. Yes. So you would never call a piston pump a blower. You always call it compressor.
Yeah.
For this, both is possible, and for a fan, you would never say it's a compressor.
Okay.
A blower.
It's a blower, yeah. All right, yeah. Okay. So, let's take a deeper look at this. And, so we've talked about blowers, fans. So, can you tell us how this is or how we can find this in the whole world of blowers and compressors?
Well, Steven, there are different kind of air blowers for the cathode side. One possibility is here to have a claw blower.
Ah, yeah, we have a diagram.
A claw compressor.
Yeah.
Two rotating claws generate a certain flow or compressed air.
So this is air coming in here.
Exactly.
And this is now the
compressed air
going out.
Okay. Going out, exactly.
And these shovels, or what do you call them, claws.
Claws, yeah. Exactly. Therefore, it's called a claw compressor.
Yeah. They grab air and move it around here. Okay.
Exactly, mm-hmm. Yes. So
this is not what you have on the table today. This is a claw compressor.
Exactly. Yeah, second possibility is a turbo blower. Mm-hmm. So basically, centrifugal forces create a certain pressure level depending on the diameter of the pump and depending on the speed. And the second possibility, what I brought here today, is a side channel blower. So we have some blades here on the impeller moving the air in circles and mm-hmm. generate a pressure which is used on the cathode side, mm-hmm. on the oxygen side of a fuel cell. Mm-hmm.
Can I just go back one? And we have here the centrifugal one. So this is air in and then air out. And this, you say, the air is basically sucked up here and just by the centrifugal force flogged into this...
Exactly.
Perimeter, yes. Which gets pushes this out.
Yeah? Exactly. Yeah. So typically, radial blowers or turbo blowers work on very high speeds.
Ah, okay.
And all therefore, right. The centrifugal forces.
Okay, that's where
push it to
where
the
you get a lot of RPMs. I think. Yeah, I've seen some.
Exactly.
That are
side
like
channel blowers normally work with less speed. So every operation principle has advantages and disadvantages.
Okay.
Like everywhere in engineering and physics.
So this is a side channel blower, and that means we have this, which we see here in the diagram, essentially the air being, where is the side channel? What is the...
Basically, this here is mm-hmm. a compression chamber, mm-hmm. this here are the silencers,
yes.
and this here is the motor.
Okay,
air-cooled Mm-hmm. You see it, the heat have to go away here. Mm-hmm. This is a permanent magnet machine. Mm-hmm. Because we focused on very high efficiency here.
Yes.
A blower on the cathode side is a parasitic load for the fuel cell, and therefore we always focused on efficiency. Permanent magnet motor are very efficient, high efficient compression chamber here, and these are silencers to reduce the noise emissions.
Yes.
But as we have a modular approach, if it, for example, is integrated in a cabinet, we also have the possibility to connect the tubes here or even on the top.
Okay. So you mentioned that the actual side channel blower is sitting in here. If we go back to our diagram shortly, I can see you took the air in here, and I did see you brought one of those with you.
Impeller, is it called?
Impeller. Okay. So this is how this would look.
Exactly.
Okay, this is the side. Oh, not the side? No.
Both sides.
Are they both sides?
Work in parallel. Exactly.
So this has, it works on both sides as well.
It works on both sides, mm-hmm. and it can be in parallel or in series, mm-hmm. depending if you need more flow,
yes.
or if you need a higher pressure. And the maximum pressure generated can be 500 millibar overpressure,
yes.
or we can create a maximum mass flow of circa 45 gram per mm-hmm. second.
Per second. So 500 millibar, half a bar, delta P, essentially.
Exactly.
Okay. So this goes in there. Okay. And then when we look at the device, and I hope you can see it this way a bit. Yeah. So this one side is the
inlet.
Okay. Inlet. So air going in here. Then.
Exactly. And then you have this impeller rotating in here. Mm-hmm. Creating mm-hmm. the overpressure, mm-hmm. the air works in cycles mm-hmm. in here, mm-hmm. in series or in parallel, and then you have the outlet on the other side.
Okay,
this
the outlet.
Is this device here.
Yeah. Has. So we turn that around, and there we can see, outlet. That's the hot side, eh?
Exactly.
Yeah, always when there's compressed air,
it gets hot, and depending on the pressure, it can be really hot.
Yeah. Here. How hot does this get?
It depends, of course, on the ambient temperature, on the pressure level generated. So in general, 60, 70 degrees in normal conditions.
Okay. So yeah, okay, that's depending on how you operate the fuel cell.
Inlet temperature, environment temperature, everything.
Do you typically have to cool the air after this before it goes into the fuel cell?
No, typically not. Oh, this is fine.
Okay, this is fine. Okay, so you mentioned these are silencers.
Or correct.
So yeah. what is in them that they take away the noise?
Basically, yes. So the construction is quite simple. Mm-hmm. This is some housing, and there are some noise damping plastics inside. So this is not the rocket science. The technology is in the motor and the compression chamber.
Ah, so okay, yeah. That, well then, let's go. The rocket science or the air blow science or the science of making. What does it take to make a good air blower? What would you know? How do I know that it's a good air blower?
Many factors mm-hmm. are relevant. For example, operation time, efficiency, of course, reliability. Robustness, there are tons of factors which have to be considered. Mm-hmm. And depending on which factors are relevant for the fuel cell, the blower has to be chosen mm-hmm. or the compressor.
Yeah, okay. So that means how much air is needed. And in terms of robustness, do these need a lot of care, a lot of tender, loving care?
No, normally those are maintenance-free.
Ah, maintenance-free.
It's a touchless working principle. Nothing touches, you don't have wear, and therefore it's, in principle, maintenance-free.
Mm-hmm. No wear, no oil. What does it take in terms of power? This one here we see?
This one is a relatively small one. Mm-hmm. It takes 600 watts, roughly. Mm-hmm. Of course, bigger blowers have a bigger motor and consume more electrical energy.
And what voltage does this one run at?
Different possibilities. So we have the possibility to run on DC, for example, 24 yes. volts, 48 yeah. volts DC, mm-hmm. or the normal 230 volts AC single phase on 50 or 60 hertz.
Okay. So 230 volts would work on normal. Okay. What do you typically see? I mean, you use these. I would not imagine that this goes on a truck, would it?
No, it's for stationary fuel solutions. The purpose is backup power units, residential or commercial units somewhere in household or whatsoever. But this is not designed for mobile application like trucks, for example, or like cars. Then people choose another design with more pressure typically.
Mm-hmm. You mentioned at some point that there is a permanent magnet.
Exactly.
More. Can you take us shed a little bit more light on what's the decision base behind that?
Permanent magnet motor is the most efficient one.
Is it
more efficient than, for example, asynchronous machines?
Is it more okay? And because I mean, sorry to interrupt you, but with all the electric vehicles coming up, we see a lot of innovations in the electric motor area as well. But
typically, those are also permanent magnet motors inside electrical cars.
So permanent magnet motors are...
There are exceptions, but as I know, the typical one is a permanent magnet motor.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Does this need anything else? A controller or something else to work with?
It's frequency controlled.
Yeah, okay.
Now here, variant is shown without the frequency converter. So in case you have an integrated frequency converter, it is on the button here.
Yes.
And the device is a little higher. But for this variant here, it can be placed somewhere else. Typically, space in cabinets is rare.
Mm-hmm.
And those, you can place it anywhere you like.
Okay, you can place it. Right. Marc, I have this one other question, and this comes from, I would say, also my early days in the business. So, okay, this obviously is sold as an air blower. But can this, sometimes you also need to move the hydrogen around or other gases. Can this also handle hydrogen?
No, this is not possible because this is designed for air. If it's designed for hydrogen, few other design criteria need to be considered.
Mm-hmm.
And as you know, hydrogen has a very low modular weight and therefore typically turbo blowers with very high speed or claw compressors are used in this kind of application.
Okay, so
on the anode side.
So that means the side channel principle is not much used for hydrogen.
It's not at all used
not at all.
for the hydrogen side, exactly. If you have a very low modular weight, the pressure, the delta P goes down, and then this is not enough anymore.
Okay, and just maybe to fan that out, so air and any, you guys just specialize this on air supply or cathode blowers in fuel cell system. This is particularly for that.
Correctly, yeah. This pump here is particularly designed for that. We are the first generation because, as I said, we started in 2005. This is not exclusively for the fuel cell business, but the main purpose was to serve as a stationary, as a cathode blower in stationary fuel cells.
And is it widely used already?
Yeah.
Okay. Wonderful. Yeah, this is very interesting. I mean, as engineers, they source these products. They think about what variant to take, and you have all these things. So thank you very much for taking the time to explain this to us. And I know that Becker has been involved in the air supply of fuel cell systems for a longer time already. So that's good. I would like to see companies hanging on to build the industry and also profiting from that. So good that you're now in the second generation already.
And yeah, we are focusing on a green future, and there are lots of diesel generators which need to be replaced in the future. And I personally am also pretty confident that we see some small heat electricity combined units in any households, residential, commercial applications, and those possibly work with fuel cells.
Yeah. And with devices like these.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, Marc, thank you very much for taking the time to show us this. Thank you for taking us inside your product and also understanding the difference between blowers and compressors. So if you are looking for more components like these, or you want to get into contact with people like Marc, on hyfindr.com you can find more components like this. Or any other things that you may need to either build combined heat systems, as he has just mentioned, or any other thing for the hydrogen economy. If you liked this video. Please give us a like under here or subscribe to our channel or drop some kind words on LinkedIn. All in all, thank you very much for your time, for watching. Thank you, Marc, for making it all the way here. We wish everyone out there success in getting their projects going in the hydrogen economy. Thanks again. All the best from us here.
Thank you, Steven.
Keep well. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.